It's been nearly 10 days since this attack took place. How much closer are you to bringing the perpetrators to justice?
So far, we have detained about 8 people who has been part of the attack on that night. And we have identified some of the leaders who right now we are pursuing.
And these individuals, which group are they affiliated with?
The ones which we are looking for, which we think they are the leader of it, most of them are from splinter group, who they were part of Ansar al-Shia at one point in time, but really they are far extremist on their own.
Were there any foreigners amongst them, ties to groups like al-Qaeda?
No, they are all Libyans.
Have you then determined that this attack was pre-planned?
Oh, I think it is. I think it is, because the way it has taken place, the way they have done it, clearly this group has planned it.
So
it is not a spontaneous thing that took place at that night, no.
These groups have existed for quite some time now. The U.S. itself has been monitoring some of their activities in the East. Why have they not been pursued before they could pose such a significant and devastating threat?
We are working in such a way that we avoid any bloodshed to be taken between Libyans themselves. We are not going to go tomorrow and confront these groups, because they haven't. Unless they will do, as a group, they will do something which is, again, committed something which is not right, then clearly we go after them. What I'm saying is, as our plan, as we go on, we have to win a lot of people around them to bring them back to the community, to the society. And then those who they will stay as extremists, then we will have all options at the right time and the right moment.
In your meetings with the Deputy Secretary of State, William Burns, what did you discuss and did you ask the U.S. for help?
It is technical, it is intelligence, and also at the same time, clearly we want to train our new army, our police force, equipment for them. These are types of assistance and also planning and strategy.
Since this attack took place, there has been an increase in drone activity. The U.S. has moved its naval warships. Has there been any discussion about a possible U.S. military strike? And what is your position on that?
We are against any action to be taken by any foreign country in Libya, because this will cross our sovereignty. And we are prepared to handle this situation. And I think the administration, they know very well what we can do and our effort. And they're very grateful, I think, for what we have done so far. And so I think we might need help in the investigation itself, but clearly for having a strike in Libya that will throw this country in a chaos if that ever happened.